South Korea has taken a big step forward in making its latest K-2 tank a completely homegrown piece of military hardware. The military says the new tank will help it close its numerical shortfall against North Korea. Our Kim Hyun-bin reports.
The last batch of 100 K2 Black Panther tanks, installed with a combination of a German-made engine and transmission systems, were put into service this year. The combinations are often referred to as power packs. South Korea started developing its own power packs in 2005, but the military knocked them back as they weren't deemed powerful or reliable enough. That is until now. Nearly a decade after development began, Korean power packs are now being fitted to the South Korean military's K2 tanks. The power packs enabled the tank to go from 0 to 32 kilometers an hour in just 8.7 seconds. Officials say that makes them fast enough to evade enemy anti-tank missiles.
The next batch of K2 tanks will fit future battlefield environments as they have enhanced mobility, firepower, and defense features.
North Korea has a sizable advantage over South Korea when it comes to the number of tanks it has, but most are believed to be antiquated. The North Korean military has 3,500 tanks at its disposal. The South, just 2,400. So plans to reduce the numerical gap by dispatching these latest tanks.
K2 tanks are far more advanced than the previous K1, so when they are fully deployed, South Korea will have the North Korean military on its toes.
The South Korean military says K2 Black Panther tanks will be in service by 2017. Officials hope to also sell the K2 to overseas buyers in the coming years. Kim Hyun-bin, Arirang News.